research geomorphology and my research hydrology just fit together.
As I was growing up, my mother's father, my grandfather, gave me two career options. He said, you can become a doctor of people or a doctor of forests. And I always loved being out in the forest and chose to go into forestry. When I graduated, I started working with a forest company, and because they were doing fantastic stuff, ecology and hydrology, watershed management. But as I worked with them over a series of months, I realized that in order to get something done through a company, you had to convince your supervisor that it was a good idea, and then the supervisor had to go up through the company, and then the company had to approach the government in order to get approval to do things. And I realized that if I worked in government and I convinced my supervisor that I had a good idea, it happens. My role has evolved over the years, so when it was just the Ministry of Forests, the BC Forest Service, my job was to do research into forest land use and the stream environments. Over the years, my position has evolved to include groundwater, so it's really gone from forest land use to very broadly defined hydrology.
Dave Wilford, first, he's a bit of a character in a really positive way. He's the original Renaissance guy. He's a farmer, sheep farmer. He's a family man. He's an incredible scientist. He knows his stuff, top of his game, highly respected across the province. Very diligent. That's critical. That's his base. But second, he's also willing to step outside and help work on the application of his science to management problems and get involved in the messy world of management problems. And then third is his people contribution. Not only his contribution to helping his team as a team leader, but the role he plays in mentoring people, other scientists he hasn't worked with before, other staff.
I think one of the bigger accomplishments that Dave's had in the public service is his water tool. Because it's used by so many people and it's used by so many different industries, and it's working its way across the province. So I think that's having a large effect on the way we manage our water resources.
So the BC Water Tool, the idea was that they could use a modeling approach and put it into a GIS map base that would support people in evaluating water use applications. The whole concept went viral. People demanded it in Northwest BC and then the Ominika. And then we did the Caribou, and we've completed the Kootenai boundary. Last year, in 2018, 6,000 watershed reports were downloaded from the BC Water Tool. And I worked with an economist, and we put a value of $5,000 on every report. The aha moment for me was, that's $30 million in 1 year of opportunity value.
One of Dave's super important achievements and contributions has been his participation in the Critical Incident Stress Management Program. And that's basically a program of peer counseling. So if someone goes through a critical incident at work, either the death of a colleague or an incident on site, an accident or something that creates an emotional trauma for that person, they have peer counselors who can help them understand the impact it's having on them.
I don't know, I guess you could call him an ultimate volunteer. And that, you know, he's always willing to support people, whether it's through the hospice or the critical incident or the local groups.
Is your police checkup today?
We're the only hospice in BC that lends out beds. We've got bedside tables and a bunch of other support mechanisms for people in their final stages of life. So that's been very rewarding, supporting people in the community.
So I'd say Dave's biggest legacy is showing us that we could do things first in a really balanced way, doing it healthy, doing it fun, working really hard and contributing and smiling every day, and contributing to a positive work environment that both was doing cool things, producing really important work, and being a productive place where people are, you know, engaged and happy and really getting along well.
I mean, I think that what he showed me was how I can pursue my passion and continue to work and do what I want to do within government.
So when I think of legacy in my career, I'm thinking of the science that I've done and my team has done, but also the support to people, the Critical Incident Stress Management Program. I'd say that support to people is an important part of what I want to see as my legacy.